Hey everyone, this is Lisa from the Rhinestone World. So in this video, I'm going to give you a quick design tutorial on how to add an outline around your text. So this is a cool effect to do because it can kind of define your text a little bit more, and it works really well with athletic designs. So let's go ahead and open up a new document, and I'm going to do it with the last name. Now this works great in a lot of different contexts, especially this time of year. Right now the Olympics are going on, so it looks great for the Olympics. But let's go through here, and I'm going to choose my athletic font. So I'm going to use this font I have here called Freshman. And so now I have my name right here. Now, one thing to note is because I'm doing an outline around these, I need my letters themselves to be a little bit further apart. So we're going to go over to character spacing, and I'm just going to increase it a little bit. Now, I'm going to make it a little bit further apart maybe than I think I need, because I can always bring them closer together as I'm done. So I have that all set. So now I'm done with my text, so I'm going to go ahead and convert this over to an object. So let's right click and then convert to path. So now this is an object, not text. I can't retype it, but it makes it a little bit easier to work with. So now really an outline is a set of lines outside of my object. So we need to take advantage of our offset panel. So let's open our offset panel. And so now this is where we have to kind of start thinking about what we're doing. So let's go right here and do offset. And so this distance that I'm putting in right now is how far away from my letter my line is going to start. So let's go ahead and preview it and do a smaller distance, maybe 0.04. Now I'm going to hit enter to preview. And so that's kind of close, so I'll go ahead and do 0.06 and hit enter. So that's nice. Maybe I'll just split the difference and put 0.05. So I have that set. So that's my first one, and then hit apply. Now this is going to be ungrouped, so I like to go ahead while this is still selected. I'm going to do Control E on my keyboard, and I just made that a compound path. I grouped it together. So right now, this is in reality just two layers sitting on top of each other. So let's click one of these. I'll turn that red, and then I'll click one of these, and let's turn this blue. Okay, so this, if I were to do this right now, I would have to layer vinyl on top of vinyl. So I want space between my letters and my outline. So what we're going to do is we're going to choose our outline that we just made, and we are going to make an offset off of that. Okay, so let's go ahead and do an offset. And so this dictates how thick our line is going to be. So we're going to make it thicker than what we set it away from our object. So let's try 0.08. Let's hit enter. And so I think that looks pretty good. So let's hit apply, and then I'm very quickly gonna do Control E to make that a compound path. So let's go ahead and bring this off of here. So these are my two lines that I've made off of it. So let me go ahead, I'll put that back, and I'll color this in a different color so we can get a visualization of what we're working with. Okay, so we have three colors going on right now. What I'm looking for is my text, space, and then a line. So what we need to do is I'm gonna zoom in, is we need to tell Silhouette Studio, hey, make this line and this line work together to make one shape. So I'm going to click right here and drag until I hit one and then two. As soon as it touches a line, it'll select it. So now I have my two lines selected, and this next part's really easy. We're just going to make a compound path. So you can either do Control E on your keyboard or right click, make compound path. So now we've converted that to an outline. Let's turn that blue. And now we have our outline text, really easy. And if we wanted this to be one color, that looks great too. We would just select both of those and we can right click, make compound path again. So now you have this nice outlined athletic font. So I think it really adds to your design. It kind of defines a little bit more. A lot of times, especially if you're using maybe a glitter vinyl or you're pressing onto something that's textured or patterned, if you don't have an outline around it, you kind of lose it a little bit. So this kind of makes sure it's legible and it stands out on your material. So if you have any questions, you can comment below or you can email us at info@therhinestoneworld.com.